everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We should have a good one on tap here today. It's the Bills coming in at 13-0, going up against the Browns, who come in at 2-11. With that, let's send you up to Snowy Orchard Park outside of Buffalo, where we say hello to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Gentlemen, stay warm.
All right, we appreciate it, Larry. It's our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Today, we reach Week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the Cleveland Browns and the Buffalo Bills. Hello, everybody. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And, Charles, you take a look at the Bills entering play here. They've been flawless all year long as they hit the home stretch at 13-0.
And now they just have to guard against complacency. You still got to go out and earn it every week.
Meanwhile, for the Browns here, whatever promise they had to start the season fully. Again on first down, Peterson. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line. On the tackle that time, Bruce Irvin. And here comes play number six on this drive. To throw on second down is Newton. Over the middle, he hits Austin. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly. Looking for his tight end, Clay, and it's intercepted. It's the linebacker, Michael Kendricks. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings. Down, here's a run with Peterson. And a nice little quick spin move before he's dropped. And a pretty good gain.
Not ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of the district driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? That's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them. It's really simple to say that they know their identity, that they are a passing team. But one of the reasons that they're so successful, they know how to mix in the run and make sure that they keep the...
And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. David Johnson, his third touchdown now on the year. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Here's Newton now on second down. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. Give him three on the play, and it'll be third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion. It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch. A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
From the red zone now, it's McCarron, and the grab by Croft. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it. He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Tyler Croft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. McCarron to throw once more. That is caught at the 7-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Six plays got him down here. This is play number 7, third and goal.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And Zuerlein's kick is good. Side, they're playing press coverage. McCarron on first down. Getting it out left side to Sanu. It's a pickup of 14 there, and that'll be good for a Cleveland first.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Red zone opportunity.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
His pass caught at the 4. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the 2-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the 2-minute signal.
They'll run. This is Cobb. And he will make his way back to where he started from, and that's all, as we will make our way to the 2-minute warning. A reminder coming up at halftime, while the two of us head for warmer areas of the press box, we'll be sending you to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Send me to Orlando.
Under pressure now, and he's going to go down just inside the 5-yard line. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. And Zuerlein's kick is good, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. The Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Simple slant route, and partner, really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
Green 39, green 39.
McCarron to throw on 2nd down. Now they go screen, it's complete. And this one goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. So he loses 3 yards there. Now 3rd down.
3rd and 5, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. Here's McCarron to throw. And that's complete to Croft. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Fresh set of downs here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. On 1st and 10, here's A.J. McCarron. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Blue 90.
And again, it's McCarron. Looking for someone to throw to. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Mohamed Sanu, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Browns have taken the lead. At the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the 2nd half. They've got great field position, obviously, to start this drive. Tie game, do you maybe go a little riskier here with that great field position?
I think some guys look at it and say, let's go. Be aggressive, be bold, let's get it downfield right now. Other guys will look at it and say, you know something? I think we're in a position to get 3 points if we don't make any big mistakes. Run our offense, get in that spot, and see if you get the 3, and hopefully.
And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Charles Clay, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Bills use the short field to their advantage. One receiver left, three to the right.
Let's go. Green 39.
Throwing on first. Here's McCarron surveying the field. Still back there. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And down inside the 15 he goes. To the offense lining up first and 10.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field. It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And McCarron will try again on second. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on.
The good signal callers will never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
He lost two, and it brings up fourth. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the right hash, this from 33. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Here we go. 3-19.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. David Cobb, his fourth touchdown on the year. And once again, the Browns are back in front.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking the offensive line.
First down, it's Newton. He's got time in the pocket. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. A long drive here. Play 12 coming up for the offense.
Everyone's got four down. Sit right there at three.
Second and 10, Newton again. It's caught on the right side at Smith. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
It's a loss of 10 yards on the play, and that'll make it third and 13. Third and long, it's Newton. This is Johnson, he's got it. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost four there, and it's third down. A long way to go for the offense here on third down.
Back-to-back runs that were stacked up. Offensively, now you've got to think to yourself, do we change blocking assignments? Do we change formations? Do we change looks in order to try and get the running game going?
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. So a big kick forthcoming here for Josh Brown. Right hash mark, a 42-yard attempt. And the 13-year man puts it through. And the Bills have tied the game here in the fourth. Gets ready to head back onto the field. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not odd, not joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Now Newton over the middle, and it's caught. Brandon Marshall, a really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. And now the offense operates in the red zone. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Partners, a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. Devin Smith, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Bills use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route, ordinarily it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me.
Mohamed Sanu with nobody ahead of him. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Mohamed Sanu with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that into the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Adrian Peterson now getting ready to go again on offense. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went into halftime, made a few adjustments, and you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play. Because a lot of times you get beat down in the first half, it gets ugly in the second half. They've come out with a new resolve and a renewed determination.
They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Here's Newton now on second down. Over the middle to Smith. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. To throw is Newton. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
But, partner, anytime someone tells me that fundamentals are leaving the game, I'm going to show them this play because they couldn't get to the passer. So what do you have to do? Get your hands up in the passing lane, and they batted it away on a third down attempt.
They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Browns offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, one pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. They'll run with Cobb. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Great play there off the end. Question, Charles. In a 4-3, you hear about the D tackles a lot. What's the role of the ends?
What they want to do is control the edges of the defense. And you always hear about an offense talking about setting the edge in the run.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Now Cobb. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now a carry for Cobb. And he stopped immediately there. And now the Bills are going to stop it as they call a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Here's Cobb. And here's another tackle made at the line. So they're converging well on the football now. Now the Bills will take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll give it to him right up the gut. But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. And he nailed it. It's good. Through the snowflakes, he finds a way to get it to go. And it's pandemonium in the dog pound as the Browns are going to win the football game.
This is one of those games where you hate that anybody has to lose. So many points, so many great offensive outputs individually and collectively, but somebody had to go down.
And even the losing team had fun, although they won't admit it to us here in the media. But they had a blast because that kind of football, back and forth, touchdown after touchdown, it's fun for everyone. But the winning team, they had a little bit more fun than everyone else.
So for Cleveland, it's just their third win on the campaign as they move to 3-11 on the year. And they will head home next week to take on the San Diego Chargers. Meanwhile, for Buffalo, this could turn out to be the right time of the season for a wake-up call as they do drop to 13-1 now on the year. And they will be at home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. Now we just have to deal with a snow-filled parking lot as we say so long from Buffalo.
I'm just looking forward to getting warm.